And that was 24 hours navigable, and that is where the town was most vulnerable. So this is one of Lamu's most prominent leaders, and that is why the National Museums of Kenya is putting all this effort to preserve his tomb, to preserve his memories, and to preserve the memories of this important urban ensemble. The tomb right here belongs to Zahid Ngumi, perhaps one of the most prominent Liwalis in Lamu's history. Zahid Ngumi is famed for his wise leadership during one of the most tumultuous times of Lamu. And this is a period when she was facing a lot of challenges between herself and fellow independent city-states, most particularly city-state of Mombasa and the city-state of Pate. And they were, of course, trying to outdo each other in controlling the coastal trade at that period. Zahid Ngumi will be most remembered for his poetry. There was a lot of exchanges between him and the people of Pate, using a lot of wisdom in exchanging heated words, but in a very decent way, in a very somber way, trying to settle their scores. But most prominently, Zahid Ngumi was the Liwali of Lamu during one of the most heated battles, and this is the Battle of Shela, where the joint forces of Mombasa and Pate lost to Lamu somewhere around Shela, in what has now become the Vita of Yakudugu. After that, Zahid Ngumi initiated the construction of the Lamu Fort to protect the city from our most vulnerable position, which was the southeast corner, or rather the southeast direction, seawards.
Is it a little bit? Huh? Is it a little bit? 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 Is it a little b